I'd like to welcome you to Sunday service at St. Catherine's Spiritual Baptist Church in the Toronto area. We have Sister Renee leading the song service today. God bless you as you watch and enjoy with us in all the name but in Jesus Almighty name.
Thank you. Thank you. coming. John saw them coming, rolling wide. They are the number.
Oh, Hallelujah.
In Jesus' name.
So glad I'm here in Jesus' name. So
I'm Thank you. most merciful Father, we have bought and shepherd, and raised up our sheep. We have followed the advice and desire of our hearts. We have fed against our laws. We have left them on those things that are not of God.
And we have done those things that we have not of God.
And there is no health in us, but our Lord have mercy upon us, our miserable offenders. Stay in our doors, confess their fault.
Restore the presence
of all
the
life
promises
and
spirit unto mankind in
praise
Jesus,
O
Lord.
And grant us the most merciful Father for the sake that we may have the living God be the presence of our life. Amen. Father, walk in heaven, Lord, be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation. Deliver us from all evil, for thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
O Lord, open our eyes.
And our mouth shall support thy praise. Thou mayest please to save us, O Lord, and rest and help us. Glory be to the Father,
to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning.
The Holy that keepeth Israel shall stand as long as the Lord is thy keeper, the Lord is thy shield on the right hand. The sun shall not set thee any good morning. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil.
He shall preserve thy soul. He shall preserve thy blood coming in from this day forth.
God the Father, Creator of heaven and earth, and Jesus Christ, the Son of the Lord, who by the same word of God's Spirit, the Father of the
He sent him to him and sit on the right hand of God the Father.
From then shall come to judge the living. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Church. No body and life everlasting. Unto the hills from whence cometh my help. My help come from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper, the Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil, shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in, from this time forth and even forevermore. Amen. Father, and to the Son.
Glory.
and see the mighty God resolving today.
Yes. Hallelujah.
You know, when things happen within the world, like earthquake, hurricane,
oh yes,
all different kind of disaster, and the mighty God passing over us, what if we just remember there's a mighty God that we are serving?
Yes.
Because when he opened the earthquake, he could take all of us in.
Yes.
What he's saying already for us there, so that's why we have to serve the mighty God. Praise the Lord this evening. I know whom I'm serving.
Oh, yes.
That's why all times say I put my trust in him. Mm-hmm. Not in man. Because man is faith. Praise the Lord. The fourth evening lesson will be Psalms 90. Hallelujah.
The Lord,
mighty
Lord.
God this evening. Praise the Lord.
Praise him.
Psalms 90, 90. Praise the Lord. Psalms 90 here, beginning from the first verse, we fall from them. Lord, thou hast been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountain were brought forth, or even thou hast formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. Thou turnest man to destruction and said, return, ye children of men. For 1,000 years is in thy sight, are but as yesterday when it is past, and as at watch in the night. Thou carriest them away as with the flood. They are as asleep. In the morning they are like grass which groweth up. In the morning it flourisheth and groweth up. In the evening it is cut down and withered. For we are consumed by thine anger, and by thy wrath are we troubled. Thou hast set our iniquity before thee, our secret sins in the light of thy countenance. For all our days are passed away in thy wrath. We spend our years as a tale that is told. The days of our years are 70 years and 10. And if by reason of strength there be 80 years, yet is their strength labor and sorrow, for it is soon cut off and we fly away. Who knoweth the power of thy anger? Even according to thy fears, so is thy wrath. So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. Return, O Lord, how long? And let it repent thee concerning thy servant. O satisfy us all with thy mercy, that we may rejoice and be glad all our days. Make us glad according to thy days wherein thou hast afflicted us, and the years wherein we have seen evil. Let thy work appear unto thy servant, and thy glory unto their children. And let the beauty of the Lord our God be upon us, and establish thou the work of our hands upon us. Yea, the work of our hands establish thou it. Here in it, Psalms 90, continued 70 verses.
Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, world without end.
There's a sad day's coming.
Yes. A sad day's coming. Yes. A sad day's coming. Are you ready?
We got news from Nigeria on Friday that one of our in-laws was having social drinks with friends the night before because he was so happy and excited because all his kids were going to be together for the first time in a long time. That was Thursday night. Friday, people saw him along the way at home, and by afternoon, he was dead, a dead man, mid-60s. What is man?
What is man?
What is man? And we all have to live our life, every minute, every hour, every day. It's been the last, every second, we don't know. I greet you this afternoon in not a name, but in Jesus' almighty name. Good afternoon to Pastor Leverson, Mother Swan, Mother Cora, Mother Anne, Mother Cherry, all diversities of gifts in the house this evening, even the little children in our midst. I greet you all in not a name, but in Jesus' almighty name. My reading for today, I took upon myself to read Psalms 8. Out of babes and suckling hast thou ordained strength because of thy enemy, that thou mightest still the enemy of and the avenger. When I consider thy heaven, the works of thy finger, the moon and the stars, which thou hast ordained, what is man that thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that thou should visit. For thou hast made him a little lower than the angel, and hast crowned him with glory and honor. Thou madest him to have dominion over thy works of thy hand, and thou hast put all things under his feet. Verse 7. All sheep and oxen, yea, and the beasts of the field, the fowls of the air, and the fish of the sea, and whatsoever passeth through the part of the sea. O Lord our God, how excellent is thy name in all the earth. And there's a song that said, O Lord our God, how excellent is thy name.
Excellent Jesus.
Praise God. I rest at the night. Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, now and ever shall be.
Amen.
Thank you. Yes.
The foundation lesson was taken from the Luke chapter 2.
I mean, the people don't want to praise you, excellent in all the earth. I mean, the people don't want to praise you.
Thank you.
David L. Alpha. As I begin, and it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This census first took place while Caiaphas was governor in Syria. So all went to register, everyone to his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judah, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his brother wife, who was with child. So it came to pass that while they were there, the day will come, please, for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped in swaddling, in clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Now there were in the same country shepherds lying out in the field, keeping watching over their flocks by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings, for great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be the sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men." So it was, when the angel had gone away from them into heaven, that the shepherds said to one another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem, and see this thing that has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us." And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. Now when they were seeing him, they made widely known the saying which was told to them concerning this child. And all those who heard it marveled at those things which were told to them by the shepherd. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. Then the shepherd returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen it as it was told to them. I rest at the 20th verse by saying,
"My soul has magnified the Lord, and my spirit has rejoiced in God my Savior. For he has regarded the holiness of his handmaid. For behold, from henceforth all generations shall call him blessed. For he that is mighty and magnified is. And holy is his name, and his mercy is on them that fear him throughout all generations. He has shown strength with his hands. He has set the broad imagination of their hearts. He has put on the mighty from the sea, and exalted the humble and meek. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent empty away. promise of our fathers.
Amen.